This video is sponsored by PureVPN. This is the iPhone XS and this is the Pixel 2 XL and they are both flagship phones from their respective companies and there's a huge advert campaign for both of their camera capabilities. But which one is the best at actually taking a decent photo? Well, let's find out. PureVPN is an easy way to keep your browsing data secure on all of your devices. With over 2,000 VPN servers and a 31-day money-back guarantee, they offer top-notch protection and great pricing. Check it out at the link in the video description below. In terms of camera hardware, both of these phones are really actually quite different. The iPhone has two 12 megapixel cameras, one with an f1.8 aperture, 28mm lens and a 1.4 micron pixel size with optical image stabilization. And along with that, we have a 56mm equivalent f2.4 lens with a 1.0 micron pixel size and also with OIS. Both of these cameras use Apple's new HDR technology and can shoot up to 4K at 60 frames a second. The Pixel takes a very different approach to camera tech with a single 12.2 megapixel sensor and an f1.8 27mm lens on top. The sensor's pixel size is exactly the same as the iPhone's main camera at 1.4 microns. And the Pixel uses Google's superior image processing software, along with its dedicated photo processing chip, to create just some awesome looking photos. Now, both of these phones have their strengths and weaknesses, but cameras are arguably the most important part of a phone, especially for my use. So as flagship and pretty damn expensive devices, you'd expect some really great photos from each of these devices. So I've been using the Pixel 2 XL for a pretty long time now, and through my use, my favorite feature is the camera on board. Even through the release of Huawei's P20 Pro and the OnePlus 6 being labeled as the world's best cameras, I still haven't seen a single photo from any other device that can beat the Pixel. But with the release of the new iPhone XS, Apple have been showing off what they're calling the best iPhone camera yet. So how does it stack up in comparison to the Pixel? Well, with these side-by-side photos that I've been taking the past couple of days, the first thing I've noticed is that the tone of the XS is really not that great compared to the Pixel. Take this photo for example. The Pixel, in this case, has a much more natural color to the photo, whereas the iPhone has a more of a cyan tint to the image. At a crop, the detail on the Pixel does appear a little bit sharper, and the exposure is just slightly over on some parts of the iPhone image. And I actually posted both of these images on Twitter and asked you guys to decide on which one you thought was the best, and it was a resounding yes for the Pixel. Color accuracy appears to be a problem with the XS, at least in comparison to the Pixel. Take this photo as an example. In the details, the exposure, the color accuracy, and just overall quality, the Pixel is so much more accurate than the iPhone. With the iPhone, it's as if it's slightly overexposing in the highlights, and the color balance is just off quite often. And all of this has seemed to be a trend for my use. Photos such as this really illustrate Apple's inability to create accurate colors through their software, and it is actually quite disappointing. In fact, some of these photos look just really inaccurate, with things like edge contrast creating some weird color effects. For me, the Pixel nails the shot every time, and it just looks great, but the iPhone looks like it's been photoshopped badly. But this doesn't mean that the iPhone's camera is terrible. In fact, in the 48 hours that I've had with it, it has taken some decent photos, but I just know for a fact that the Pixel would do a much better job in the same situation. The same thing can be said for the portrait mode on these cameras. Both of these photos were taken the same length away from me at pretty much exactly the same time, in exactly the same lighting, and the Pixel is just so much more detail accurate. Sure, you can adjust the bokeh on the iPhone, but I'd rather a decent object separation than that. In fact, take a look at this other example of portrait mode that I've taken here. The Pixel isn't perfect, and in fact, it has missed out some of what I would call the chain of this basket, but the iPhone has completely blurred that out as if it's a piece of the background. And the edge around the basket itself is also just terrible on the iPhone, whereas it's actually really respectable on the Pixel. The fact that the iPhone has dual cameras means that it should be able to discern objects that are closer or further away from the lens, and Apple said this is a feature of this iPhone in their keynote, but if you cover up the top lens, nothing changes, so it's not being used that way. In low light, both of these cameras do struggle, as will any other phone, but as the trend seems to be going, there is significantly less detail loss in the Pixel, and significantly more on the iPhone. And remember, both of these cameras are shooting in the default mode that enables the HDR from stock, and I haven't changed any of the settings on them, they are just shooting like they would out of the box. And that's probably just about it for my camera comparison on both of these phones. To me, the Pixel 2's camera is still the best in the business, and it always has been since the release. This new iPhone has had a pretty big marketing campaign for its cameras, but for me, it's been quite an underwhelming experience. Out of these two flagships, the Pixel 2 XL nails the photo every time. It's probably the best camera that you can get on a smartphone right now. Out of any photo I've ever seen from a different phone, this phone included, the Pixel 2 XL blows them all out of the water. For me, this is still the best smartphone camera out there right now. PureVPN is an easy way to keep all of your browsing data secure on all of your devices. With over 2,000 VPN servers designed to meet any purpose, from unblocking Netflix to getting the best security possible, PureVPN offers top-notch protection with great pricing. Check it out at the link in the video description below.